Okay, let's try this once again. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you may be in this beautiful planet of ours. This is Marc Lanehart, the Intuitive Prospector. I apologize as Facebook actually, somebody was actually trying to intercede on my account. And so during the broadcast that started at 8 a.m., I try to start at 8 a.m. for Metaphysical Mocha Mondays, and I think we were about 11 minutes into the message, and all of a sudden, Facebook kicked me out because it looked like somebody was trying to hack my account or get into my account. So I apologize for the delay. I apologize, but it is, from a security standpoint, it's a good thing. So if you guys would do me a favor, please share out. I'm not able to share out to other pages. I was trying to, and it said because of the activity on my account that I'm not allowed to right now, because the account is was under, it looks like it was under attack. So try to do it one more time here. Yeah, temporarily blocked. So it looks like I'm not able to share out, like only post on my page. So if you guys would be so kind to share out to other pages, Soul Adventures, if you're on the Soul Adventures closed group page, if you're on Inspired Living Radio page, the Intuitive Prospector page, or Marc Lanehart. So good morning. Grab your coffee, grab your tea, grab your protein shake. I've got Yoda this morning. Recapping on what I was talking about before Facebook took me down off of... because my account was being hacked. So it said, your account is under attack and we have blocked your account. So I had to go back and I had to create a new password, write it down, and that's what took me for the delay to get back on. So just a few more minutes for people just to get back onto the live stream. Make sure, if you're not following me, make sure to turn on the notification. There should be a turn on or share with others. Make sure to turn that on and also check out my YouTube library, because you can catch all of these videos, Inspired Living Radio, Metaphysical Mochas, over off my YouTube library, which is the Intuitive Prospector, and there is a link in the description field of this video. But Facebook was protecting me, so that's a good thing. So if you guys, thank you, Paula, for sharing out. Paula just shared out to a page, to Soul Adventures, which is our closed page of about 3,100 spiritual prospectors. So if you want to get on the page, it's called Soul Adventures. It's a community for sharing what your journey is, what you're going through. And today I was talking about the Serenity Prayer before I got cut off. I was talking about things that we can do for serenity, and things, you know, I was talking about, you know, because it talks about God grant me the serenity, whatever your God is, whether you're a believer, an agnostic, an atheist, whatever your belief system is. Today is about and wisdom to know the difference. Where do we access that wisdom? Where do we gain that wisdom? And during meditation this morning, I plan all my shows out first thing in the morning when I get up. I do some meditation, I do some Qigong, and just sit with what I'm picking up on conscious energy, the world energy, because the world is pretty chaotic right now, I'll agree. But there's good news. Mercury is out of retrograde. It's gone back into alignment. So there's going to be a lot of energy for the next couple days for you guys that are very empathic or very creative. Harness that creative energy. Harness the energy that's around you, because you can really create some really cool things. So now that Mercury retrograde is over, and it happens about three times a year, but this was a pretty intense Mercury retrograde because it went into Leo, which is a very fire sign. It also had a full lunar eclipse, which is the longest of the 21st century, so a lot of energy. So now we're on the backside of that, so this is a great time to really sign a contract, go on a trip, do a new project, get creative, and do something. But the wisdom and wisdom to know the difference is what I was talking about. I was also giving a shout out to all the firefighters down in California, up in Canada, here in Washington State. We're pretty smoked in. There's actually an air advisory out right now where you're not even supposed to go outside because the smoke, it's not behind me. That's a backdrop. It looks like fog. It's that thick, and there's a lot of people that are stuck indoors today because of the smoke. But I want to give a shout out to all the firefighters, all the first responders, all the pilots, all of the wildland firefighters, all of those folks that put their life on the line every day to serve, to protect, to keep us safe, and know that we have people like that that are giving their time and sacrificing and being away from their families to fight these tremendous, horrific fires. I believe it's the largest fire in California state history now. So The world is hot, and we want to make sure that those firefighters, so if you see a firefighter, first responder, thank them. Thank them. Go up and shake their hand. Smile at them. Give them a hug. Say thank you for doing what you do. As a retired firefighter, I definitely appreciate that, and I just want to give a shout out to all of them. So let's talk about and wisdom to know the difference. How do we get to wisdom? What is wisdom? I'm short on time because Facebook locked me out because somebody was trying to hack my account, so I had to change my password and all that. But the serenity prayer goes like this. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and wisdom to know the difference. So that's your mantra for this week, is the serenity prayer. I use it a lot because it really is the accepting things I cannot change. The ego wants to always be in control. The ego wants to be right. And for me, the serenity prayer helps me to be humble, to stay humble. You know, because there's a lot of people, one of the hardest things we can do is to smile in the face of people that are mean or demeaning or not civil. And we're seeing a lot of that. We're seeing people with losing lack of civility, moving into their own tribe, a way of thinking and not seeing another person's perspective. And so it's a very interesting time. And so I use this prayer a lot to grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change and the courage to change the things I can. And that's what Mocha Monday, Metaphysical Mocha Mondays is, guys. It's the courage to get on Facebook Live and to change the things I can, even if it's one person at a time. And I know that there's some of you that are watching this morning. Thank you for hanging out. I know some of you personally, some of you are in my spiritual development group every Wednesday and support the work I do. And I just want to say I appreciate you. I honor you. I honor your journey. And thank you for hanging out with me this morning. Some of you I don't know, please make sure to say hi in the comment section. I'm not responding right now to any of the comments, so if you're posting comments, I have them turned off. And the reason I have them turned off is that's how the format of the show goes. I spend that first half hour with a spiritual message, a topic. I give you a totem animal spirit, a crystal, and a numerology number for the week. And then I will log off and turn back on because this video uploads to my YouTube library. And then I turn around and I come back on the Intuitive Prospector page and we do the prospecting Q&A after show, which is going to be starting right now. But I'm going to let me get into my message and then I'll follow up with questions afterwards if that's okay with everybody, just because the fact I lost about 10 minutes when Facebook locked me out because somebody was trying to actually hack my account and get in to change some of the things. So please share out. Please have your cup of coffee. Taking a nice deep breath with me. Let's get into the magic of the moment and talk about and wisdom to know the difference. How do we get to that wisdom? The first thing that I've always followed in my spiritual path, and just sharing this with you guys, is education leads us to knowledge. And when we start to have education, whether it's in the form of college, whether it's in vocation, for me it was mediumship and going to England every year for the last 5 years to study the vocation of what mediumship is and the understanding of spiritualism and spiritual healing and psychic sciences and have an understanding of what that is. Completely different from my undergrad in business management that I have and my graduate studies in sports medicine and human performance that I have. Completely different forms of education. But wherever you're at on your journey, apply education. Keep learning. Life, we're here at Earth University is what I call it. We are students of life. We're here to learn and to grow and to transform. That's why we chose to come here as spiritual beings first, having a physical human experience second. And some of us lose that. We get into the physicality of our bodies, the 9-to-5 job, and we lose that we are so much more than what we perceive to be. And when we want to get into the wisdom, education can lead us down that path. Whatever form of education that inspires you, draws interest to you, you have a passion for, explore that through the power of education, because education leads us to knowledge. It leads us to greater awareness, and awareness is the greatest agent for change. When we have that awareness and when we start to learn the language of our soul, which I call intuition. Intuition is the language of the soul. It's like learning a new language, Spanish, French, German, English, and practicing and applying what you want to learn. And with the wisdom from education comes knowledge. Knowledge leads us to wisdom, and we get wisdom also through a lot of our life experiences. So for those of us that are in our 40s, middle ages, we've had some life experiences, and we can apply the wisdom of what we've learned based on. So, you know, it really, there is a lot of truth to the older we get, the more wiser we become because of the experiences, because of the life lessons, not because of the failures, because for me, failure is first attempt in learning. I always apply everything to learning. Some of the lessons are hard. The waves of change are always constant, but I try to be a big wave surfer and get on my surfboard of life and surf those waves so I don't find myself underneath them. So I always try to apply it to the aspect of always moving forward and always learning. And so one of the things that you can do to instill and activate your wisdom is the power of education, the power of awareness, the power of your own intuition to understand your life journey. We get a lot of intuition and we get a lot of wisdom also through coffee, as Yoda would say. So get a drink of your coffee or your hemp-infused, non-psychoactive protein shake with strawberries, banana, and chocolate love hemp, which I drink every morning now. Feeling great. So if you want to learn more about the hemp oil, the CBD oil, the protein powder, what I'm a part of now as an affiliate of Prime My Body, and my company's name is called Awareness. If you want to learn more about the amazing plant of hemp, send me a private message, an email, or put a comment in the section, and I'll get back to you on that. That's part of the wisdom, understanding how nature can play a big part in our diet, in our role, how we can learn from nature, how we can heal from nature, how we can engineer things from nature. Some of the creativity that I was just talking about, now that we're past the Mercury retrograde, get out into nature, guys. You can be inspired through the energy of nature and Mother Earth to do some pretty cool things. We were just this Friday at Denny Creek Water Slide, which is a natural water slide up in the mountains. And it was a lot of fun. We got up there early. There wasn't a lot of people. The water was low, so we didn't get to do the water slide. But the whole area was ours for like almost an hour before people started showing up. But there was a lot of smoke, so it made for a tough hike as far as the exchange of oxygen. It was pretty tough, I'll have to admit. But getting out in nature can inspire you and lead you to some pretty amazing places, which is part of wisdom. And knowing what wisdom is to know the difference, because you're going to have challenges. You're going to be faced with a fork in the road, and it's your wisdom that allows you to choose the right path for you. There is no right or wrong in my opinion. It's choosing what's right and best for your higher self and your higher path. So one of the things that you can do for also in instilling wisdom and wisdom to know the difference is having an attitude for gratitude. When you start the morning off, when you start your day off, because that's all you have today is right now, guys. No future, because future is not set, and you can't do anything about the past. It's our imagination into the future that creates the future. It makes it real. It's our memories into the past that creates our past and makes our past real. But neither one is real. All we have is the magic in the moment. And one of the things that I always wake up with is a attitude for gratitude. I call it the Grateful Eight. Eight things that I'm thankful for. And each morning I try to be thankful for the different things. My eyelashes, my elbows to make my arm, you know, work. My fingers, the ability to write. Coffee. These are things that I instill, because when you have gratitude and you instill that in your pathway, it's also just becoming more wise and using that wisdom and the wisdom to know the difference, because your gratitude changes your vibration, it changes your signal, it changes your frequency, it changes your mindset. So that would be one recommendation, is attitude for gratitude. Start each morning, because again, there are things that we take for granted: a roof over our head, clean drinking water, warm water to take a shower, food that you can actually go out and get on demand. There are places around the world, guys, that as a humanitarian, and I've been to some of these countries, I've built schools in other countries, they are simple and they're grateful for just what they have. So a reminder to have an attitude for gratitude. Letting go. Letting go can also unlock the wisdom door. When you're holding on and dragging that suitcase of what you didn't do, or the what if world, or what should I have done, it's not instilling your wisdom, because you're not living in the present moment, you're living in the past, and that doesn't amplify your wisdom. It actually takes away from your higher self. So letting go, hold on and get dragged, or let go and be free, is the old adage, as the Japanese proverb goes, I believe it's Japanese, that talks about holding on or letting go. My recommendation, if you want to start knowing your own wisdom and wisdom to know the difference, you got to let go of your past. If you hold on to your past, you're living in your past, and that's not a real place to be. So letting go. Forgiveness. Forgiveness is a huge piece of this, guys. Forgiveness for yourself, forgiveness for others. That's part of becoming wise and accepting. And meditation, the power of meditation, the power of Qigong, the power of yoga, the power of Kung Fu, the power of Tai Chi. Doing things that get the body moving can instill different forms of meditation. Planting a garden, surfing, paddleboarding, hiking, all different forms of meditation. But those four things can really start to help with your wisdom. And again, today's message is about the serenity prayer, but taking just that last piece of the prayer that says, and wisdom to know the difference. How do I access my own wisdom to know the difference for your own pathway? So just want to give you a few things for your week. This is Metaphysical Mocha Mondays with Marc Lanehart, the Intuitive Prospector. And I just want to inspire you to tap into the creative energy this week, because we're after the Mercury retrograde, so a lot of energy is going to be coming your way. Be patient, be kind, be caring, be compassionate. Watch your thoughts as far as getting into any tribal ways of thinking and having civility for others and being a different perspective for others. That's important, especially in this chaotic world that we're living in. But the number for today is 78, so I pulled your numerology card. It's spiritual career. So if there's some of you that are thinking about a spiritual career, because spiritual career is not always the easy path. I didn't know it would be my path years back. And it's not always rainbows and unicorns, but the spiritual path, you may have a spiritual career calling. You may be a teacher. You may be a psychic. You may be a medium. You may be a healer. You may be an inspirer. You may be a thought leader in writing. Your spiritual career, pay attention to the number 78, which is also the 15 in numerology, which adds up, 15 adds up to 6, which is about self-love. So this is all about things that you love and putting that into either a career or a business model. Okay, so that's the numerology number for this week. The animal totem spirit, the animal spirit for this week is the swan. And if you're seeing the swan, whether in digital form or in physical form in your own reality, it's a reminder that no matter what is happening in your life right now, do whatever it takes to keep your faith strong. And that's part of wisdom. Part of wisdom is to continue moving forward, to continue to move on and not give up and not give in, but give it your all. You know, in my path, I've come across people that have given up through, just checking out, suicide, mental breakdowns, and then just giving up. And sometimes it can be overwhelming. I understand that. And there can be a lot that's thrown at us. I know when I had lost both my brothers, my one brother was murdered, and 3 days later, my older brother was diagnosed terminal brain cancer. There was a lot to take on. There was a lot to work through. So I understand that. But again, if I haven't gone through the fire, the refiner's fire, to come out gold on the other side, we all go through it. But keep moving forward and keep your faith strong, whatever that faith is for you. It's important to accept your life circumstances and surrender to the will of spirit, trusting that it will all work out. And you'll soon find clarity and purpose in the confusion that you're experiencing. So for some of you that are watching this morning, you may have some confusion. You may be looking for clarity. Focus on the fact that life is precious and it's a sacred gift. And express your gratitude, like I was talking about, an attitude for gratitude and appreciation as many ways as possible. Whatever changes you're going through, go with the flow. That's what the swan is all about. That's your totem animal spirit for this week, the swan. Go with the flow. Be accepting of what is. Again, it ties into the serenity prayer. Everything that I do ties into the message. So the serenity prayer. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and wisdom to know the difference. The swan is telling you to go with the flow. So if you see the swan in your physical journey, in your soul adventure, that's just a reminder. The spiritual career, for those of you that might be thinking of a spiritual career, start to plant seeds today for the future you want in your spiritual career tomorrow. Last but not least is the crystal of the week, or the stone, the prospecting crystal or the prospecting stone. Okenite. O-K-E-N-I-T-E. I don't really know this stone, to be honest with you. This is something that I was looking in my research that would be part of the energy being soft and furry is really what the okenite. It's sourced out of India, so it's a stone coming out of India. It's easily obtained, and so the rarity is, it's not a rare stone. It's the color is usually in white, and what it does, it's one of the stones for the New Age. Is people usually want to stroke it and put it on mats to have a grounding effect, to have a it's described as a soft and furry energy is the best way I would describe okenite. Like I said, I haven't personally worked with okenite, but it was tying into today's message about going with the flow, about wisdom to know the difference. So if you have experienced okenite, O-K-E-N-I-T-E, put it in the comment section. Make sure to say hi to people. We've got about 20-some people watching that's part of the spiritual community, part of the spiritual prospectors. Make sure to say hi to one another, where you're from. It's all about community, and it's about sharing knowledge, because like I said, knowledge and education leads us to wisdom, and that's today's message, and wisdom to know the difference. That's today's topic. So again, it's a furry energy. It's a soft, furry energy. It actually, if you place okanite, it actually clears obstacles from your path and promotes stamina to finish your life task. So that's the reason I picked it, because you can place it around if you're having obstacles at work, if you're having obstacles with your family or your love life. Place okanite in the space where the problems are occurring to clear that energy, to open up that pathway for you, so you can go with the flow and have a smooth journey, and also in wisdom to know the difference. So that's today's message. Again, thanks for hanging out. I'm over time. I'm going to shut down. I'll be back in about 2 minutes for the prospecting Q&A after show. Thank you so much for hanging out. I apologize. Facebook, my account was being hacked, so Facebook took me down real quick. I was able to get back up and running, but my account's temporarily locked as well. So hopefully I can get back up on the page. But if you want to hang out with me, join me next week at 8 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, 11 a.m. Eastern, for Metaphysical Mocha Mondays every Monday morning here on the Intuitive Prospector page. You can also catch me every Wisdom Wednesday through the internet, through Inspired Living Radio in our third season. We'll be live on the air this Wednesday at 12 p.m. Pacific, 3 p.m. Eastern. You can access from anywhere in the world, any device. Just go to Om Times Radio or the link off my page at marklanehart.com. And you can call into the live show. You can post a question on our closed Facebook page. If you want to become a member, an inspired listener, just join our closed Facebook page, and you can always post a question there. And we usually bring them live to air. We like to interact with our inspired listeners. And if you want to work with me directly via in-person, video, phone, visit marklanehart.com, internet search Intuitive Prospector. If you have questions about spiritual development, if you have questions about online training, some of the classes I teach through the online format at Learn It Live, happy to talk with you about that, help you with your own spiritual prospecting for your own spiritual gold, or as I like to say, dare to dream, dare to explore, dare to live. Want to thank you for hanging out with me this week. Think about the mantra, the serenity prayer, and wisdom to know the difference. How are you accessing your own wisdom? Are you finding gratitude in your journey and for your today? Are you letting go of the things that don't serve your higher path or your higher self? Are you forgiving yourself, forgiving others in your journey? Because that's all part of wisdom, and also through the power of different meditations and connecting to self, because the only way out is in, and that's the best part of the journey, is going within to find who you truly are. So I want to thank you for hanging out. Until our next soul adventure, be kind, be caring, be compassionate, and I'll see you next week. Happy prospecting. Namaste.